Yo, what's going on, guys? It's your boy Toad Dash here, and today I want to start a new series called Rogue University. And what this series is going to be, it's going to be a little series of me going over tips and tricks inside the game, how to play certain rogues, solo strategies on different game modes such as Demolition, Strikeout, Extraction, as well as rogue solo strategies on these same game modes, as well as try to get some teamwork and, like, you know, team game, team strategies as well to help you guys out as we get closer and closer to rank. So this episode we're going to be talking about controller bindings, so I hope you guys enjoy. Other than that, sit back and enjoy, man. Alrighty, just some audio settings, but to start off with, I play with no hold to crouch, no hold to sprint, no auto sprint, none of that. Then we go down to horizontal controller sensitivity, which is 9.5, and then my vertical controller sensitivity, I have at 8.5, but I do feel like I do go back and change it to 7.5 or 7, because 8.5 is a little wonky, as you can see right here. Just go down, change it to 8, then like, I don't know, and let's change it around 7.5, 8, that's a good level. ADS, I have it at 80, vertical, 50. Then my dead zones, I like to play with 0.06 on the left stick and around 0.04 or 0.05 on the right stick. It's just up to your controller, pretty much. And then for acceleration boosts, just 30%, 1.1. I'm pretty sure those are like the normal ones. I don't know. I don't think I changed that pretty much. And then my ADS mode, I have it hold as like you normally should. Scope sensitivity, 74 horizontal, 50 vertical. Invert y-axis off, vibrations off. But I'm pretty sure I still feel vibrations on my controller. Then I have the reload interact button, press to reload, hold to interact. Pretty much the basics here. And then hold time 0.2, double press 0.2. And I don't play with any motion sensor stuff, so all of that's pretty much default too. Then we're gonna go over to the bindings after this. And the bindings I have, pretty much, I didn't change the gameplay bindings at all. Besides, I think maybe the ping may be different, but I'm pretty sure the ping has always been up. So my open shop is down on the D-pad, scoreboard, the touchpad, or whatever it is on an Xbox controller, the select button. Then my emote spray, have it on the left. But I don't really emote or use quips or team comms like that, so that's just pretty much up to you guys how you want to jumble around and use that per se. And then we're gonna get over to the movements and the better stuff, as I'd like to put it. Now we got over to the movement, and everything's pretty much normal except my crouch is right on the D-pad. I don't crouch that much, nor do I feel it's necessary unless I'm going up behind cover and then I crouch. I don't like crouch spam or nothing like that, so I feel like the D-pad is the perfect spot to put it. Then my dodge roll, I have it circle because you use a dodge a lot in this game, so I'm always spamming circle. And then my aim, I got it for L2. My shot, I'm pretty sure is R2, which is still all pretty normal. And then my interact is the X button because I have square to be my melee, because I like that better. And gadgets, R1. Shoulder toggle, I really think everyone should switch that to R3. I'm pretty sure it's R1 at first, but I recommend you switch to R3. L1, R1 on the abilities. R3 on swap gadgets, you know, helps you swap faster in my opinion. The triangle button is normal, as I said, the melee, square. And then the gameplay, I don't really do anything like that, but I also have my jump for L1 because it helps better with like jump shooting in my opinion, so I recommend you guys change it to that. Other than that, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.